Good morning, children of standard 7 A and B. So we shall continue with a new chapter, that is fiber to fabric. Okay, children. Now we all know that we wear different variety of clothes. And different variety of clothes are worn in different seasons. Rainy season, winter season, summer season. Like children, we take hairs of animals. Okay? See, we get hairs from, what's the meaning of this hairs is? Hairs means, I mean to tell, fleece. Hairs of animals. Hairs of animals is called as fleece. So we get fleece from plants. We get hairs from animals. So we get this fleece from plant products also and animal products also. Especially we depend upon fleece means hairs of animals. So we are depending upon so many animals, like to tell you goat, okay, and yak, and sheep. We depend upon sometimes like camels also, and so many animals are there, like alpaca and like llama. These alpaca, llama, these we can find these animals in we can find these animals in South America. And this yak, goat, sheep, camels, wherever we find it in hilly regions of our country, Jammu and Kashmir. So many parts are there in our country. I mean to tell now is we are taking this fleece. Fleece means what I told? Hairs of animals. Which animals? Goat, yak, sheep, camels, alpaca, llama, and all. These hairs, what I mean to tell, fleece, is being converted into fibers. From fibers, it is being further converted into, to tell you, from fibers it is converted into fabrics. Okay? Fabrics is what the clothes we wear. To tell you, children, from this fibers is being, to tell you, from fibers it can be converted into, it can be converted into woolen yarn. Okay? Woolen yarn. From woolen yarn, it is converted into fabrics. So these are the processes. From hairs, it is being converted into fibers. From fibers, it is being converted into woolen yarn. And from woolen yarn, it is converted into fabrics. Fabrics is what I mean to tell. Fabrics means is nothing but clothes. Okay, children? Then this wool, it is nothing but hairs we get from sheep, goats, and all. Then this wool giving animals, they are having a lot of wool on their body, which is going to protect the animal, that sheep or a goat, from the cold climatic conditions. Means if a sheep is having hairs, wool means what? Wool means it is nothing but the hairs on the body of the sheep. Sheep, goat, yeah, these are called by the name wool giving animals. So this wool will be on the body. It will be very thick. It can store inside that wool.
it stores lot of air. Air is called as the poor conductor of heat. So that it keeps, what keeps? Wool will store the air inside them, and it makes this air, I call it by the name poor conductor of heat. Whatever the heat which is present in the animal's body, whatever the heat that is present in the animal's body, that heat will not go out from that animal's body. What I mean to tell is, whatever the heat which is present in the body of the ship's boat, yeah, that heat which is present inside the body of these animals, boat, yak and ship, these are called by the name wool giving animals. So the heat which is present inside these wool giving animals, that heat will not go outside their body because of a thick covering of wool on their body. So wool is going to prevent the heat not to go out from the wool giving animals. As I told you that this prevents, wool is preventing the heat from inside the animal's body not to go out. It makes the animal warm and children. This wool is being cut down to make into new type of fabrics and all. Then we have two types of hairs here. We have two types of hairs on the wool giving animals. Let me make you clear here this. What is the importance of wool on wool giving animals? Which are the wool giving animals? Goat, yak, sheep. What will the wool store? Wool will be storing atmospheric air inside them. Wool will be storing atmospheric air inside them. This air being a poor conductor of heat, it will not allow the body's heat not to go out from the animal's body. Okay children, as it stores lot of heat, it is very important for the wool growth also. Let me continue with the two types of hairs on the wool giving animals. One is the coarse breed hair, thick type of hairs on the wool giving animals. Another is soft under hair, which is very much close to the body of the animal. Inside hairs close to the body, that will be very soft under hairs. Very much close connected to the body is of this goat, yak and sheep. Two types of hairs. First is coarse breed hair. Another type is soft under hair. These are hard hairs and these are soft hairs. Usually we make use of soft hairs to prepare the fabrics, to prepare our sweaters, to prepare our wearing things and all. Then what we wear, children, usually the fabrics we wear, it is made out of soft under hairs. We get it from these animals, goat, cat, sheep, camels and all. Then some type of, let me rub these things children, okay? Understood? Two types of hairs, coarse breed hair, very thick hair. Another type is soft under hair. Wool giving animals, goat, yak, sheep,
camels, alpaca, llama. These are found in South America. Children. Which animals? Alpaca and llama. These are found in South America.
Let me have the things, children. There are some special breeds. Breeds means special varieties of sheep, which we get from special type of parents. Okay, these breeds. Breeds means what? Breeds means offsprings. Offsprings means what? It is the sheep's child, smaller one. So this offsprings we are getting from the parents. Parents are so nicely selected of sheep's that these parents itself they are having good quality of wool, soft quality of wool. So that after the crossbreeding, we get a type of sheeps. We get a type of sheeps which are going to give very good quality wool, and which are in large quantities. We get quality also good, quantity also good. Only because of a process by the name. Selective breeding. What is the name? Selective breeding. This selective breeding is what I mean to tell is the parents are like that selected. The parents means what? Sheep's parents, like the parental sheep's. They are special sheep's which can give birth to those type of sheep's which can give good quality, which can give good quality wool and which can be in a larger quantities. So what I am going to get finally? Good quality wool, and another is in large quantities. Good quality wool I will get, and other is which I am going to get it in the large quantities only because of the selective breeding. Parents are both the parents, male and female, they are the one which are giving good quality wool. So after their crossbreeding, we get the offsprings which will give us lot of wool and which is of good quality. Understood? So this process is called by the name selective breeding. Okay? Then I should tell you children the animals which are found in India which are giving us lot of wool. Okay? In this, by the name, I will rub these things. This yak's wool, we find it in Tibet, Ladakh, Jammu and Kashmir. All these places are very hilly places. Okay. So we get this yak's wool also. They take it to make fabrics. So we get it from the places like Tibet, Ladakh, and Jammu and Kashmir. Then a special type of goat. The goat name is Angora goat. Okay, this Angora goat, it also gives us wool. It also gives us wool, which is specially used to make, sweaters. Where? In Jammu and Kashmir. The name of the goat is Angora goat. Wool is there. Angora wool is called by the name Angora wool. Angora wool used to make sweaters. Where we can find this Angora goat? We find it in the hill regions of Jammu and Kashmir. Okay, children. And it is also used to make. It is also used to make shawls. Whose wool? Angora goat's wool. What is called by the name Angora wool? Angora wool we get it from Angora goat. We find these animals in hilly regions of Jammu and Kashmir. So these wool are used to make shawls in Jammu and Kashmir. It is specially called by a special name that is called as Pashmina. Pashmina shawls. Pashmina shawls are made from the wool of Angora goat. We find these animals in Jammu and Kashmir. Okay, children. Further, we continue with. I have told you about the animals like llama and another one is alpaca. These are found where? These are found in South America. These also give a very good quality of wool. Okay. Then usually we see in so many parts of our country, like the hilly parts of Jammu and Kashmir, let me write those names, children. Okay, I will write these things. Okay. Let me continue with the places like Tibet, Ladakh, Jammu and Kashmir. Let me write it full. Okay. Jammu and Kashmir, Sikkim, Uttaranchal and Arunachal Pradesh. Then we have Gujarat, Rajasthan, and Haryana, Punjab. Haryana is right. Haryana. These all places: Tibet, Ladakh, Jammu and Kashmir, Sikkim, Uttaranchal, Arunachal Pradesh, Gujarat, Rajasthan, Haryana. There and of this Haryana, in all these states, the major occupation of these people is rearing of sheep. It is called by the name what? It is called by the name of what? Rearing of sheep.
rearing. Afterwards, it is after rearing, they do just they continue the process as breeding. In rearing of these animals, they take their group of sheep. Group of sheep is called by the name herds of sheep. Group of sheep they take and go now is called by the name herds of sheep. They take you to the variety of places where the lot of grasses are grown to feed these, to feed their sheep and all. Later, what they do, usually these grass eating animals, whatever I call by the name, these sheep, goats and all, yak and all, these are primarily they are eating what? Grass, plant products. So we call it by the name grass eating animals also. So, so they are called by the name herbivores. What? Herbivorous animals. These herbivorous animals, this much of food is not being sufficient for these sheep and all. These people, these shepherds and all, the man who is rearing these sheep, he is called by the name shepherd. He makes the sheep to eat plant products also, grass products also. So only these sheep are called by the name herbivorous. What? Herbivorous. Grass eating animals are called as, grass eating animals are called by the name children, what? Are called by the name herbivorous. Grass eating animals are called by the name herbivorous. Again, these people who are rearing these sheep, they make a variety of food using pulses, corns and oil seeds. Okay, they make a variety of food to feed the sheep and goats so that the sheep and goats grow very well and they start giving a good quality of wool, so that they start giving the good quality of wool. So what they make to eat these sheep? What they make to eat these sheep? Plant products, pulses, variety of pulses, corns, okay, oil seeds, maize. So they mix all these type of food grains and they make a variety of food so that the sheep can feed on these food items and they grow very well and they start giving a very good variety of wool. Okay, children. Then usually in winter seasons they don't let their sheep to go outside because it will be very cold at that time in the places like hilly places like Jammu and Kashmir and all. So these people who are rearing these sheep, they keep them inside the hut only. And these sheep will feed on dry fodder, leaves, plant products and grains, grain products and majorly dry fodder, grains and plant leaves when they are indoor, when they are inside the hut, because in winter they don't go outside to rear their sheep. They don't go outside because outside it will be very, the climatic conditions will be very cold because they have to stay indoor. So they, when they are in indoor, when they are in huts, so they are going to, feed their sheep with dry fodder, grains and food grains, variety of food grains as I have told. Pulses will be there, corn will be there, maize will be there, oil seeds will be there, okay? Then these plant leaves and all. So that they don't go outside, they are going to feed these animals indoor. Then by doing these type of things, what I told, selective breeding. Selective breeding means what? To get the offsprings, to get their daughter sheep, their daughter sheep, parent itself are of good breeds. I will write these things here. I can write it out here. Raising of sheep. good breed means good quality of sheep.
Parents are of good quality.
After their breeding, we get good children from there, like good sheep, which give us good quality wool, which give us good quality wool, and in also a large quantities. Okay, children, I hope you have all have understood till now whatever I have taught. The remaining things I am going to continue in the next class. Thank you, children.